much. It's a great pleasure to be back here at the Hugh Lane Gallery. I'm very excited to share this Cocteau program with you. The centerpiece is the Irish premiere, which you're going to hear a little later on, by Rhona, Clarke. She composed a set of pieces inspired by Jean Cocteau's drawings and sketches. And that was the starting point for this program. All the composers featured were associates and collaborators of Jean Cocteau, who, if you don't know, was an iconoclastic writer, artist, filmmaker from the early 20th century in Paris. In 1918, he wrote a manifesto called Le Coq et l'Arlequin, in which he decried Impressionism and he favored the simpler music of Erik Satie. And he also encouraged young artists to take inspiration from the music that was happening in the music halls, in the jazz clubs, circus music, and you'll hear some of those influences in these pieces. Jazz was being discovered for the first time in Paris at that time because the African American artists who had fought in the First World War decided not to go back to the United States because they found much more freedom in Paris at that time. So there's a burgeoning scene there, and the Parisians were discovering this music for the first time. So the next group of pieces is called L'Album des Six, and it's written by this collective of composers that was known as Le Groupe des Six, and it featured Auric, Duret, Millot, Poulenc, Taillefer, and Onegger. And they were a group of composers who just graduated from the Conservatoire in Paris. And Jean Cocteau was sort of their inspirational ringleader. So they collaborated on a lot of different works together. This album is the one piece of music where they each composed one short piece comprising the album. So I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. afternoon, everybody, and thank you for being here for this, the Irish premiere of Cocteau. It was first performed last Wednesday at the Centre Culturel Irlandais in Paris. So you could say that you are the second set of collective ears ever to hear this piece. And a number of years ago, several years ago now, I visited the two museums in Menton, south of France, where they are dedicated, these two museums, to the work of Jean Cocteau. As Isabelle said, he worked right across the board in all sorts of visual arts, drawings, painting, posters, design, costumes, also film, novels, poetry, just everything except music, in fact. So I was really taken with both the work, the quirkiness, the modernism of his work, and also the personality itself. So this work started by looking at some of his drawings, and if I take the first one, Antigone, for example, it's based not on Sophocles' play, but on a really little simple drawing by Cocteau, costume studies for his own version of Antigone, showing two stick figures. They look like they're about to take off and dance and do a few pirouettes. So that was the first. Numbers 2 and 5 are quite slow, and they are based on a self-portrait from 1962. And this shows just a serious, very sensitive face, but also one that is ravaged by his addiction to opium. And other movements are called after works, or in one case, a character from a work by Cocteau. And the last one, Oedipus, is a character from his play called The Infernal Machine. You'll see when you hear it. This collaboration with Isabelle had been ongoing for a couple of years. And I want to thank Linda O'Shea Farron, who's here today, because this was her idea that myself and Isabelle would get together. I also want to say sincere thanks to Mary Barnicott for her organizing and programming of today's concert. And to my gratitude to Fingal County Council, who grant aid to the commission. And what can I say of Isabelle, who has come all the way from New York via Paris to play for us today? Well, the work is dedicated to her in admiration and with my sincere gratitude.
Thank you. Thank you.